Welcome back, students. In the last class, we have completed first part of the theory. Okay, that is frequency management channel assignment. All these topics we have completed up to fixed and non-fixed channel assignment we have completed. In this class, we are moving to second part of the theory. Right? So in second part of the theory, there is cell coverage for signal and traffic. Okay, cell coverage for signal and traffic. In that, we will deal about two topics today. That is, first topic is signal reflections in flat and hilly terrain. Second topic, effect of human made structures. Okay, effect of human made structures. So, signal reflections in flat and hilly terrain. Second one is effect of human made structures. Okay, let us go to some introductory part. Okay, just an introduction about second part, that is, this cell coverage can be based on signal coverage or on traffic coverage, means cell coverage. Okay, whatever the signal fluctuations or the signal quality happening in the cell site depends on, okay, or the cell coverage depends on the signal coverage, or it depends upon the traffic, right? Next, so what we have to do? So we have to examine the service area as occurring in one of the following environments. See, in the cell site, there exist some human-made structures. Okay. Meet the signal quality of the cell coverage depends on the human-made structures and also the natural terrains. Okay. You know what is meant by terrain? Terrain. Okay. That's the geographical area existing between the cell tower and the mobile unit. Okay. It may be some water body. It may be some flat area. It may be some hilly area. It may be some valleys. Whatever it is. Okay, all together we used to say it as a terrain, a terrain contour. Anyway, we have to examine these things. What we have to examine? First one is about human-made structures. That is, it may be some building area, it may be open area, suburban area, or an urban area. Whatever it is, okay, which are done by humans. Next, second one is the natural terrains exist. Okay, it may be some a flat terrain, hilly terrain, water terrain, or by occurring through foliage losses, means some due to some afforestation, okay, trees, etc. So these things we used to discuss. Okay. So in that, this is the introductory part of the cell coverage and signal and traffic. Next, we are entering in the topic, that is signal reflections in flat and hilly terrain. Okay. Signal reflections in flat and hilly terrain. So in that, we will discuss about two things. Okay, first one, ground incident angle and elevation point. Ground incident angle and the elevation point. Okay. So let us examine this figure. Okay, we are studying this theory. The ground incident angle theta is the angle of wave arrival. Okay, here theta represents the angle of wave arrival, and incidentally pointing to the ground as shown in the figure. This pointing to the ground. The ground elevation angle phi is the angle of wave arrival. Okay. Phi means this is said to be the mobile antenna. Okay. This is said to be the mobile unit antenna. And this is said to be the elevation angle phi. Okay. Elevation angle phi, where the reflected path is reaching the mobile antenna signal. Okay. The reflected path is reaching the mobile antenna signal, as shown in the figure. Okay, so by showing the representing the figure, we are dealing about the incident angle and the elevation part. So one is the direct part from the signal tower to the mobile antenna, right? And second one part is the reflected part. Okay, so the incident angle is said to be theta. In the elevation angle, where the antenna, mobile antenna, is going to reach the signal, is phi. Okay, just we are indicating the figure. And the height of the antenna, let it be H2, height of the antenna. Okay. And height of the mobile antenna. Height of the mobile antenna is H1. Here H1 is represented. Okay. Height of the mobile antenna is H1. Okay. Here H1 is represented here. H1 is represented here. And D, what is the D? The distance between the transmitted tower to the mobile unit antenna. That is the distance D. Right? So these things we will illustrate from this figure. The next one is about example. Okay. So by considering the figure, what we can calculate, what we can do. That is, in a mobile radio environment, the average cell site antenna height is about 50 meters. What is 50 meters here? H2. Okay, here H2 is 50 meters. Next, the mobile antenna height is about 3 meters. What is mobile antenna height here? Okay, H2. This figure here, H1. Okay, here H1 is the mobile antenna height. H2 is the total height of the antenna. Okay, so 50 meters. 50 meters is cell site antenna. Okay, that is H2. H2 equal to 50 meters from the previous figure, and H1 equal to 3 meters. Okay. From this figure, H2 is 50 meters height of the cell site antenna, okay, and H1 is 3 meters, okay, that is height of the mobile antenna. So the mobile antenna height is 3 meters, and the communication path length means D from here to this mobile unit antenna, okay, that is D equal to some 5 kilometers given, okay. So what is the incident angle? The incident angle is tan theta, okay. Here tan theta equal to, take tan theta, some opposite by some adjacent, okay. That is tan theta equal to opposite to 50 meters, okay, plus 3 meters. Means here the cell site antenna height is 50, okay, and again it is reflecting again 3 meters height, okay. This one is 50 and again plus 3, so H2 plus H1, that is 50 plus 3 by adjacent is 5 kilometers, okay. So 50 plus 3 by 5, okay, so 0.61 degrees is the data. Next, elevation angle. What is the elevation angle? 5. Elevation angle of the antenna of the mobile unit, means this one. Okay, means with respect to horizontal, okay, this one, 5. What is 5? That is tan phi equal to 50 minus 3, because here we have to decrease the antenna height, because here the angle is 5, we have to decrease antenna height 3 meters. So 50 minus 3 by 5 kilometers. 50 minus 3 by 5 kilometers. That is 0.54. Okay. Next, elevation angle at the location of the mobile unit. Okay. At the location of the mobile unit, what is the elevation angle? Not the antenna, mobile unit. Okay. Here it is the elevation angle at the antenna of the mobile unit. Here, location of the mobile unit. So, location of the mobile unit means directly taking opposite side, that is 50 by 5. So 50 by 5 kilometers gives 0.57 degrees. So while dealing with this part, signal reflections in flat and hilly terrain. Okay, here the terrain is only flat. Okay. So ground incident, what is the ground incident angle and the elevation point? Okay. So elevation of the mobile antenna, elevation of the mobile unit. We have discussed these things by using some, take it as a problem, not just an analysis or an example. Okay. By using this example, we are illustrating the respective figure. Okay. Next, ground reflection angle and reflection point. So here it is some hilly terrain, not a flat terrain. It is a hilly terrain, right? So based on Snell's law, the reflection angle and incident angle are same. And since the graphical display usually exaggerate the least slope and incident angle by enlarging the vertical scale as shown figure. Okay. Even though here it is representing a hilly terrain, okay, hilly terrain, but by seeing only this part, it is considered as a flat terrain only. The reflection point on a hilly slope can be obtained by following the same method as if the reflection point were on the flat ground. Okay, since the reflection from the antenna is on the flat ground, we will follow the same analysis or the same method as the previous one, right? So here also we are taking one example. Okay, Here also we are taking an example, but here there will be two heights, okay, and there will be three heights, okay. One is the mobile unit height, mobile unit antenna height. One is the cell site antenna height. Third, what is the third one? Third one is the height of the hill. That is capital H. H equal to 100 meters. Height of the hill also we will consider here. So let H1 be 50 meters. Here H1 is given by 50 meters. H2 is 3 meters. Okay. And small d equal to 5 kilometers. And capital H equal to 100 meters as shown in the figure. Capital H equal to 100 meters as shown in the figure. What is the figure? This figure only. This is the figure. Here, small H1 equal to 50 meters is the height of the cell site, and H2 is the height of the mobile unit antenna, and capital H, height of the hill, right? These things we are considering here, and the first part we will take the approximate method, okay? That is, small d equal to d dash equal to 5 kilometers, means we are considering this distance, okay, from cell site antenna to mobile unit distance. Okay, and from bottom of the hill to mobile unit distance as same. That's why not same, but we are taking an approximate method and considering the both the distances from the cell site and the mobile unit, from the bottom of the hill to mobile unit as same. So then the slope alpha. Okay, and the slope alpha. This is the alpha. So then the slope alpha is given by. That is tan alpha equal to opposite by adjacent. Okay. So here tan alpha equal to opposite is capital H equal to 100 meters, adjacent is 5 kilometers. Okay. So tan alpha equal to, that is alpha equal to tan inverse of 100 meters by 5 kilometers, that gives the angle 1.14. Okay. So what is the incident angle? That is the slope of the hill. Okay. So what is the incident angle? That is tan theta equal to. See where the theta lies. See, tan theta equal to opposite by adjacent. Okay. Opposite is 50 plus 3. See, this analysis we have done in the previously also. Okay, in the previous example also. Okay. 50 height of the cell side plus 3 meters height of the mobile antenna by adjacent side. Adjacent side is 5 kilometers. We have taken small d and d dash. Okay, from cell site to mobile unit and the bottom of the hill to mobile unit has same distance. Okay, that is 5 kilometers, that is equal to 0.61. Right. And the reflection point location from the cell site antenna. Okay. What is the reflection point location from the cell site antenna? That is D1 equal to 50 by tan theta. Okay. Means if you take tan theta, this is a reflection point location from the cell site antenna. Okay. So we are taking D1. D1 means, so this is the D1. We are taking tan theta. Okay. Tan theta equal to 50 by adjacent. By adjacent. Opposite is 50 by D1. That is 50 by. From this, I have obtained D1 equal to 50 by tan theta. Okay, we know what is the value of tan theta, that is 0.61. Okay, 0.61, we are substituting the same value here, we are getting the value 4.7 kilometer. Okay, so I obtained the D1. Okay, D1 means from cell site to mobile unit distance. Right, so this is the approximate method, same as the previous example. Okay, but in an extra way, you have taken only the slope of the hill here. Next one is using the accurate method, the slope angle alpha of the hill is, okay, that is tan alpha equal to, here in the accurate method, we are not considering small d equal to d dash. Okay. So, tan alpha equal to, here d is not equal to d dash. D is not equal to D dash. We have to find out the D dash. Okay. So here, in the accurate method, D dash is not equal to 5 kilometers because this is not approximate method. This is the accurate method. Okay. Here, D dash is not equal to D. right? So we have to find out the adjacent distance. So tan alpha equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Okay, opposite by adjacent. Okay, tan alpha equal to 100 by that would be some d dash. Okay, here tan alpha equal to. Right here, tan alpha equal to, okay, opposite side is 100 meters by, okay, adjacent side is, let it be d dash, okay, let it be d dash, so by d dash, okay. If you take, hypothesis, okay, the hypothesis, okay, d1 dash square, okay, d1 whole square equal to, we know that d1 is 5 kilometers. We know d1 is 5 kilometers. So, take here from here we'll take d1 square equal to 100 meters 100 square plus d dash square. 100 square plus d dash square. So, d dash square equal to d1 square plus d1 square minus 100 meters, right? So what is d1? 5 kilometers, okay? So 5 kilometers square minus 100 meters square, 5 kilometers minus 100 meters square. So substitute d dash, so d1 equal to root of 5 kilometers square minus 100 meters square. Substitute d1 value here. So root of 5 kilometer square minus 100 meter square. Okay. Just take the hypothesis. Okay. Take hypothesis and you will obtain d1 dash. Okay. By substituting these values, we will get the value 1.14. So the incident angle theta and the reflection point d1 are the same as here. Okay. Here we have got 1.14. Here we have got 1.14. Okay. By taking two analysis, using the approximate method and the accurate method, we have got the same values, that is the slope of the hill, that is alpha as 1.14. Okay. This is about the topic signal reflection in flat and hilly terrain. Okay. This is with respect to flat terrain, just analyze the figure, and this is with respect to hilly terrain. Okay. Hilly terrain, we will get an extra height. That is capital H, that is the height of the hill, right? So, this is about the first topic of the today's class. Next, what about the second topic? I said I will cover two topics in this video lecture, okay? So, first one is using signal reflection in flat and hilly terrain, completed. And going to the second topic, effect of human-made structures, okay? So, how the signal is being affected by human-made structures? Okay, so what is the propagation path loss? Okay, how we will find out the propagation path loss? How to make analysis? Okay, about the path loss slope. Okay, how to find out the A path loss slope? These things we will study here. Anyway, let us go to the topic. Because the terrain configuration of each city is different, and human structures of each city is also unique. You know that. Every city has its own human-made structures, and every city terrain configuration is almost different. But of course, some urban cities will be same, some suburban cities will be same. Okay? And of course, but each city has its own structure and it is unique. The way to factor out the effect due to terrain configuration from a man-made structures is to work out a way to obtain the path loss curve for the area. So what we have to do? We have to find out the path loss curve with respect to an area, right? So the path loss curve obtained on virtually flat ground indicates the effects of signal loss due to human-made structures. So what we can do by obtaining this path loss curve? So obtaining this path loss curve, it is very easy to obtain the signal. So we can estimate at which part of the cell set where the signal loss is more, okay, where the signal loss is very less. So by identifying these things, we have to take the necessary steps in order to increase the signal quality, right? So we may have to measure the signal strength at those high spots and also at the low spots surrounding the cell sides as shown in the figure. So here in this figure, this is the cell site. Let us take it as a cell site. Okay, the center one is the red dot is the cell site antenna. So with respect to the cell site antenna, what we are considering, what are the mainly affected areas? Okay, where the signal quality is very less. What are the high spots? What are the low spots? Okay, where the signal quality is very low. Okay, where the more signal fluctuation is there, we will identify those things as a high spots and the low spots with respect to the signal strength. Okay, so by identifying these things, we have to make a path loss curve, right? So the propagation path loss curve for movement structures for selecting the measurement areas. First, we will measure the areas, we will find out the areas, and with a 1 mile intercept or a 2 mile intercept, we will find out the path loss curve. So the average path loss slope, which is a combination of measurements from high spots and low spots. See, by identifying the high spots with respect to signal strength and identifying the low spots with respect to signal strength, okay, radio pass in general area represents the signal received as if it is from a flat area affected only by a different local human made structure environment. So the identification of these parts is important, and identification of whether the flat area is affected or a hilly area is affected is also important. So by using 1 mile intercepts, 1 mile intercept means for every 1 kilometer, we used to identify the signal quality with respect to that area, and we have to make sure that whether it is a high spot or a low spot. We are using a 1 mile intercept as a starting point for obtaining the path loss score. Okay. So for every 1 mile, we used to identify where the signal strength is high and where is the signal strength is low. Okay. And what is the path loss score for every 1 mile intercept? Is to obtain. So with respect to distance, so what is the power obtained and what is the path loss curve obtained? So therefore, the differences in area to area prediction curves are due to different man-made structures. So with respect to area, the path loss curve changes because those are due to human-made structures. The measurements made in urban areas are different from those in suburban and open areas. So the measurements in open areas, suburban areas, urban areas varies, right? And any area to area prediction model can be used as first step toward achieving the point to point prediction model. Next, area to area prediction model, which is described here, can be represented by two parameters. Okay, with respect to area, we have to estimate one prediction model with respect to path loss curve. So that is by using a 1 mile intercept points and by using a path loss slope. 1 mile intercept point is the power received at the distance of 1 mile from the transmitter. As we move away from the transmitter, what is the power we are obtaining? Okay. Not only power, we used to calculate not only power but also the path loss slope. These are the two general approaches to finding the values of two parameters experimentally. Okay. So first one, here P naught, power is obtained in free space. And also gamma, the propagation path loss is also obtained. Okay. So compare an area of interest with an area of similar human made structures which represents a curve such as a shown in figure. So if we go on moving 1 mile intercept from the away from the transmitter, we are obtaining the respective power or the signal strength with respect to distance. As the distance increases, so what is the curve we are obtaining with respect to path loss and with respect to power? So this figure represents that with respect to urban area, open area, suburban area, and some cities are taken like Tokyo, Japan, New York, like. Okay. And second one is, if human made structures of the city are different from the cities. Okay, we have taken some cities. Okay, we have taken one examples of some urban cities or suburban cities here. Okay, if the we are taking a new city which is different from the analysis, a simple measurement should be carried out. So how to measure the slope there? Set up a transmitting antenna at the center of the general area. Okay, there will be some antenna at the center. Okay. By moving away from the transmitter, for every 1 mile intercept, we used to calculate these things. As long as the building height is comparable, if you compare the height of the building with respect to the height of the transmitting antenna, if you are able to compare that, then it is very easy to find out the path loss curve. Okay, that is mentioned here. And also, it is mentioned that to take any 6 or 7 measured data points and to take the high and low spots with regarding, then compute the average of 1 mile data points and of 10 mile data points. So, up to 1 to 10 miles, take the data points and make sure that to analyze these things and draw a path loss curve. So, if the area is very hilly, then the data points measured at a given distance from these base stations in different locations can be applied. Okay. If it is a hilly area, then the path loss curve used to change. And in this case, you may take more measured data points to obtain the average path loss slope. So, if it is a flat terrain, for every mile intercept, it is easy to take and easy to analyze, and you can easily make a path loss curve. If it is a hilly terrain, if it is a hilly area, we have to make sure that we have to take n number of points, n number of intercepts. We have to increase the number of intercepts not to find out the path loss slope exactly. The terrain of the hilly area is generally sloped. Then we have to convert the data points that were measured on the sloped terrain to a flat terrain. So the conversion, we have to convert the hilly area points to data points to flat area points. Okay, that is done by delta G. Okay, and the conversion is based on the effective antenna height gain. That is delta G equal to effective antenna height gain equal to 20 log HE by H. Okay, H1 is the actual height, HE is the effective antenna height with respect to 1 mile to 10 mile locations. And the last one is about path loss phenomena. Okay, here we have taken three figures are there. Okay, so first figure represents when the base station antenna is located in the city, then the 1 mile intercept could be very low, the slope is flattened out as shown as Tokyo slope. Okay, here the mobile units are moving away from the antenna. Here you can see some irregular man-made structures. Okay, so some are high and going through out of the city, the structures are very low. So the signal strength is flattened out and gamma value is less than 40 dB per decade. Okay. Next one, when the base station is located outside the city, the intercept could be much higher, the slope is deeper as shown by the Newark curve. Okay. So here is the antenna height, here is the cell set antenna, and very far from the antenna, see, find out the distance here with respect to antenna, the buildings are very near. Okay, within the, here what is the first point represent? The base station is located in the city. If it is located in the city represents with respect to this tower, with respect to this tower, okay, the building structures, the building human-made structures are very near to tower. Okay, very near to tower indicates that the base station is located in the city. Very near to tower indicates that the tower exists, the cell site antenna tower exists in the city, and the 1 mile intercept could be very low, and the slope is flattened out as shown by Tokyo's curve. We used to say it as a Tokyo's curve. Okay, that is the first figure represents. Second figure represents when the base station is located outside the city. Outside the city represents, this is the cell site antenna. Okay, and the buildings are far. The buildings are very, very far. Okay, and here they are very close. Means this is the city. Okay. If it is in the city, here the buildings are very close. We know that in the cities, the buildings are very close. As we move away from the city or away from your town, there will be very rare buildings occurred at a very far distances. Okay. So the buildings are very near. The cell site antenna is in the city. The buildings are here. Here they are near. So the cell site is far from the city. Right? You have to assume like that. So the base station located outside the city, the intercept could be much higher and the slope is deeper as shown by the Newark curve. Slope is deeper. At first the signal strength will be very high. As the mobile unit is moving away from the distance, okay, and the signal strength decreases drastically. That is the deepest curve obtained here. Next, when the structures are uniformly distributed, depending on the density, the 1 mile intercept could be high or low. And the slope may also be at
40 dB per decade.
Here in this figure, in the third figure, we can see that the cell site antenna and the buildings, the human-made structures are equally distributed. So here we are obtaining the propagation path loss flow, that is gamma equal to 40 dB per decade. So this is just an analysis with respect to path loss, propagation path loss. As the mobility is moving away from the city, or the cell site antenna is at the city. Remember one thing, simple point, the buildings are very close here, so this is the city. Here the buildings are very close here, this is the city. So the cell site antenna is very far. Here the cell site antenna is very far, but of course the human-made structures, buildings are uniformly distributed. Then the path loss slope obtained, that is gamma, is equal to 40 dB per decade. Okay. So this is about today's class. So in this class, we have covered two topics. That is, first topic, signal reflections in flat and hilly terrain, and second topic is effect of human-made structures. Thank you.